get the hour on this stuff. I'm gonna break your heart.
Ready to begin?
No worries.
Yes, thank you.
All right, good evening, everyone. Is the panel ready to proceed?
We are.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is the date and time scheduled in the matter of the Independent Citizen Police Review Board of the City of Pittsburgh on behalf of Mr. Charles Crawley versus Pittsburgh Bureau of Police Officer Joseph Lippert, badge number 4280. The case is CPRB number 72-16. The panel consists of Mr. Thomas Water, Dr. Mary Jo Garcia, and Sister Patrice Hughes. I'm Elizabeth Kalura, and I'll be the hearing officer, and the matter is being transcribed by Morris Scantberg and Hodge, Inc. court reporter, and being live streamed on the internet with a copy archived by Donna Carpenter. Will the special prosecutor representing the executive director represent or identify himself for the record, please?
Thank you. Jeff Reuter.
Thank you, Mr. Reuter. And is the complainant, Mr. Charles Crawley, present today?
Yes, he is. Yes.
Thank you, Mr. Crawley. And is the subject officer, Joseph Lippert, present today?
Yes, he is.
Thank you. And counsel for the subject officer, please identify yourself for the record.
Christopher Symbolic on behalf of the officer, Lippert.
As a preliminary matter, I request that Ms. Pittenger, as executive director, read into the record the series of entries regarding notification and charges.
Thank you, Madam Solicitor. Good evening, members. We are required to provide public notice in advance of these public hearings. Public notice was published in the Post-Gazette, the New Pittsburgh Courier, and the Pittsburgh City Paper of this public hearing on March 8th of 2017. The officer was subpoenaed to appear tonight on March 9th, and Mr. Crawley, the complainant, was subpoenaed to be here tonight, served on March the 13th. The pre-hearing conference for this matter was held February 28th, 2017. When Officer Lippert was here for the pre-hearing conference, we encouraged having representation, but we did make the file available to the officer and or his counsel. On Friday, Mr. Zavala advised us that he was representing the officer. We provided a number of documents. We tried a couple different ways. We were ultimately successful and did provide a number of documents that were listed on the evidence list that was given to the officer at the pre-hearing conference. And the file, of course, remains open until such time as this hearing is convened.
Charges?
No.
And at this time, it's customary for you to read the full charges into the record, but will the officer waive the reading of the charges? They are the charges that have been presented to you on paper.
Yes, we waive reading of the charges.
And do members of the panel, do you wish the charges to be read or do you wish them to be waived? Any particular reason why you want the red into the record? Are there any other matters that need to be addressed before we proceed on to the record?
If I may, Hearing Officer. Hearing Officer, prior to today's hearing, just a few minutes ago, I spoke with Mr. Symbolic. Am I mispronouncing your name, sir? Mr. Symbolic, and discussed whether or not his client, Officer Lippert, would be availing himself to testify today. Complainant intends to call Officer Lippert as an essential part of the case in chief, and Mr. Symbolic explained that his client was refusing to participate in today's hearing, citing an argument that's certainly been present before the board before related to his obligations under the collective bargaining agreement. As such, we're going to move that this be memorialized and seek the opportunity to have the board decide how it wants us to proceed in this matter, either by enforcing the subpoena independently or by having a complainant seek to enforce the subpoena itself.
Mr. Reuter, so you served a subpoena on the subject officer, which was served on him, compelling him to attend today?
I think, I might have misspoke. I believe that he was only served with the notice of the hearing today, and I believe it was the understanding, or I think it's, I'm uncertain of the language in there. I don't believe he was served with the subpoena.
Yes, but he was served with subpoena summoning him to appear this evening for the purpose of providing testimony to the panel.
And that subpoena was issued under the subpoena power of the CPRB pursuant to the ordinance that establishes and governs the CPRB?
That's correct.
And the subject officer is here in attendance, and am I correct that he is refusing to take a stand and testify in any way?
Christopher Cimbala here on behalf of the complainant. You are correct. The officer is here, as is required by the subpoena, pursuant to Section 21, Subsection C of the party's collective bargaining agreement, the parties being City of Pittsburgh and the Fraternal Order of Police Lodge Number 1. He is invoking his right to forego testimony in today's hearing.
Mr. Cimbala, you recognize that the City of Pittsburgh is not a party to this proceeding, correct?
I recognize that.
And you recognize that the Citizen Police Review Board is not a party to this collective bargaining agreement that you are citing?
It does not specifically reference in the recognition section that the Citizens Police Review Board is a party.
Okay. And you are taking this position notwithstanding the CPRB ordinance, the ordinance creating the CPRB, as well as its duties and powers, that specifically states that CPRB has its own independent subpoena power?
I did not look at the ordinance, to be quite honest with you. We're invoking our right under the CBA.
Okay. Understood. Are there any other matters that need to be put on the record at this point?
No.
Nothing additional from the complaint.
Then at this point, we are going to continue the hearing so that the CPRB may take such steps as it deems necessary to enforce the subpoena to compel Officer Lippert to testify and participate. The continued date will be at a date set amongst the parties that is convenient to all participants, and we will have nothing further today.
If I could, before we go off the record, I'd like to move for the of the excerpt from the collective bargaining agreement that I had offered.
The court reporter will attach this excerpt as an exhibit to the transcript. However, it's not evidence because the hearing didn't begin. No witnesses were sworn. So as a procedural matter, I think it's appropriate to attach it to the transcript as an exhibit, but it's not evidence before the board because it's not related to the substance of the charges alleged.
Okay. All right.
Thank you.
Thank you.